Welcome to the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. It's day two of the speed skating competition, and in this session, we'll be featuring the women's 3,000 metres and the men's 5,000 metre events. And we're here at the James Sheffield Olympic Skating Rink. And as you can see, the conditions are looking pretty good. It's a little chilly outside, but the skaters and the coaches are expecting some really good times today. First up will be the women's 3,000 metre final. Our start list has 11 pairs going head to head, but it's all about time and consistency, building up the speed through the 7.5 laps of the 400 metre oval here just outside the Olympic Museum. That is Karai Maho, representing Taito Bunker University from Japan, up against the Hungarian from the Budapest University of Technology and Economics, Abigail Merks. So pair number six, our first Japanese and Hungarian athletes out. Hungary known for their speed skating prowess. So still 2 seconds in time. Can she find a little bit more time and threaten this track record? Track record that has been in place here for 43 years. She's still motoring hard, Karai Maho. Gonna get the bell.
One to go.
Just dropping away here. Just slowing up a tiny bit, but still with a good chance of taking the lead here from Kung Soo Min. Coming into the final bend, the Japanese athlete, has she got more left? She looks like she's still motoring through the bend. Merck's trailing now, still maintained a sort of 50 meter gap, but still behind. But it's all about whether Karai can challenge Kung. She comes into the finish straight. And it's a 33-39. We're getting ever so close to the track record being beaten here as Merck's comes over the line at a 4:44.10. So student at the Academy of Physical Education in Katowice, Poland, Olga Kaczmarek, and a student from the Korea National Sports University, representing her university and Korea, Park Ji-woo. Keep an eye on her, finished 13th in the 1,000 metres at the Olympic Games in Beijing in 2022. So 7.5 laps of the track to complete for pair number nine.
Here we go. Pair number nine.
Clean start from the pair of them. Amazing. Park Ji-woo is getting faster here. Another 5 tenths taken out of the time there. Next time round, she'll get the bell. Kaczmarek dropping down to fifth. She's got to keep it up though. She's got a chance here. She can power through the last couple of bends. And look, Park still pushing hard. Coming into the home straight. 500 meters left to go in this race for her. She's still got plenty in those legs by the looks of things. Gets the bell and smashing the time here. That's another 2 seconds taken out of the time in that last lap. She's getting faster and faster. The coach is encouraging her to keep going because Merrick gets the bell as well. She's dropping down now into sixth place. But you can see how hard Park is working now. 4:33:37. That's the time at the top at the moment of the leaderboard. The legs are burning hard here. She's going to cross the line here. And 5 seconds clear of 4:28:18. And that has taken the track record here. Provisionally, we have to wait for the timekeepers to give us that. A 4:32:13 set by Norway's Bjørg Ava Jensen at the 1980 Olympic Games here in Lake Placid on this track. A record that's been in place for 43 years. We can see how much energy she's expended. There is confirmation, a 4:28:18 for Park Ji-woo. We move straight on. So pair number 10, Canada's Laval University student Rose-Anne Grenier goes up against the Czech Republic's College of Economics Zlin, Susanna Kosova. Kosova on the outer ring, and here's the Canadian. Can the Canadian break the All-Asian top three as it currently stands? Rose-Anne Grenier now in provisional second place. Just under a second off the split time set by Park Ji-woo going through 2.2 kilometers. The next split will be with 400 meters remaining. Park Ji-woo went through it at 3:51:82. Rose-Anne Grenier gets the bell. What's the split time? Still outside, just under a second, 400 meters to go. She sits in provisional second at the moment, chasing down Park Ji-woo, who powered through the last 3.5 laps. Kosova dropping away into seventh position, but it's the Canadian. This is all about the Canadian. Can she get that 4:28:18?
Top of the stretch.
Final bend, powering out on the outer track. Is this going to be enough to challenge for the top spot? 4:28:18 set, and it's second place. A 4:29:11 pushes the Canadian up into second position provisionally. We're just going to wait for confirmation. It looks like we're going to get that. So Park Ji-woo still with the best time of a 4:28:18. But Grenier from Canada moves into second place. But Canadian has broken up the Asian party at the top of the leaderboard. Now there is the leader. And we come to our final pair. Canada represented again, University of Calgary student Laura Anne Hall goes up against the Technical University of Liberec student representing the Czech Republic, Veronika Antosova. 4:33:37, the time to beat to get into the medals. 4:28:18, the time to beat to get on top of the podium.
This is our last pair of women.
Very similar technique and gait from the pair of them. So still pushing hard, both of them. Kosova in touching distance as well here. Provisional seventh place for her. Hall provisionally third. Now we start looking at the time set. 2:03:20 set by Park Ji-woo, who leads this women's 3,000 meters at the next split, which is 1.4 kilometers, nearly the halfway point. And look at that, Laura Anne Hall inside the time, and Antosova is also closing up on the top times as well. She moves up from provisional seventh to provisional fifth. 3:51.82 was the time set by Park Ji-woo. Are we still ahead? We are more than 3 seconds ahead here. The last 400 meters, and Laura Ann Hall is pressing harder. She's really going for this. She knows there's an opportunity here to set a massive new track record and a tough one to beat. The conditions very good here in Lake Placid. Laura Ann Hall going for gold here in the 3,000 meters. She's still powering out of the last bend and into the final 100 meters. She's coming up to the line. What is this time going to be? It's going to be huge, I am sure. Crossing the line 2.5 seconds, nearly faster than Park Ji-woo to set a new track record. Park Ji-woo there just pushed down into second position. In the end, Veronika Antosova from the Czech Republic could only do enough for fifth place, a 4:34.14 for her. But Laura Ann Hall of Canada wins the women's 3,000 meters. It was an impressive performance. Laura Ann Hall knew she had it in her, sets a new track record of 4:25.70. So confirmation, Laura Ann Hall of Canada setting a new track record, the second time the record was broken today, to win gold from Ji-woo Park, who had originally broken the track record, and Canada get a second spot on the podium in Rose Anne Grenier. Turn our attention now to the men's 5,000 meters final. We have 11 pairs and one single going out in this final, contesting four gold, silver and bronze. And the longest distance the men will compete over at this beautiful arena. Representing Hungary and the University of Debrecen, it's Balint Bodai, and here representing Switzerland and the University of Lausanne, Thibaut Metcro. Underway in this 5,000 meter. Fastest time set by Burke Finstow-Refsas in the last pairing. 7:07.13. Starting to get like we might be challenging that 43-year-old track record set by the USA's Eric Heiden. 1980 at the Olympic Games, 7:02.29. The time set for the best track record, and conditions looking pretty good here as well. Balint Bodai has just slipped away a little bit, a 36:26 final 400 meters pushes him down into fourth place as we split the line again at the 3K mark. 4:13.16. Now pulling away by a second, and as you can see, Balint Bodai is falling further and further behind. 6:33.22, the time set by Refsas at this split. Still 3 seconds inside, but just starting to drift off a little bit. A 34:12, our final 400 meters. Well, just 300 odd to go now. Both arms swinging, trying to build up as much speed, even on the straights here. Still powering down, still got something left in the tank. And Thibaut Metcro coming up to the line, final 100 meters here. Balint in seventh. How close is this going to be? It's the closest we've seen so far to the track record being beaten, a 7:03.65. What a performance from Thibaut Metcro, powering down right the way through, putting it down on the straights, the last two straights, for a 7:03.63 at the halfway stage. The Swiss skater leads the men's 5,000. We go to pair number 10, representing Italy and the University of Milan. It's Riccardo Lorello. And representing both Japan and Senshu University, it's Arito Motonaga. Impressive junior careers for the pair of these.
Ready.
Can they challenge Metro, Ressas and Fitzgerald at the top of the order in the men's 5,000 metres here at the speed skating? Well, look at these times, a 30.39 from Arito. That is fast. That is super fast. And still 7.55 seconds ahead. They're both keeping this gap now. It's almost like they've settled into their speed. Bit of conservation perhaps going on to put in a final explosion at the end. But boy, oh boy, this would be an impressive time if they can keep going. Arito leading the way throughout, but just in the last 600-700 metres, Loretto has put down the afterburners again. Closing the gap on Arito, but Arito still leading now, builds it up to nearly 8 seconds. 7.86 seconds in the lead, the Japanese athlete. Both staying relaxed, but Loretto now crucially switches to the inside track in that transition. And is he going to cut the line first for the first time in the race? I think he is. 4.2 kilometers. And now 8.2 seconds inside that. Loretto had some extra energy through laps 9 and 10. Now leading the way. And has Arito blown up here? You can see a grimace on his face. He's holding his legs. That is not a good sign. Meanwhile, Loretto is powering on. Looks very relaxed, taking in the oxygen, just thinking about technique. He gets the bell. 9 seconds clear of Metro. A 7:03.63, the best time set by the Swiss skater. The target for the lead here in the race. A 7:02.29 is the lap record that's been standing for 43 years. Loretto coming around the final bend. He is in contention here for the top spot. He's in contention here for the track record. Loretto from Italy pushes for the line the last few meters. He comes across and the time is a terrific 6:53.23, smashing the track record by nearly 10 seconds and taking the lead. Arito Motonaga holds on to take second place in the standings, provisional second place, of course. He was burnt up with 2.5 laps to go, but somehow the Japanese athlete held on. But this is the man that everyone's going to be talking about right now. Riccardo Loretto of Italy has blown the track record apart. Here is Arito. He was looking so strong through 11 laps, but he lost it coming around the final bend. He just did not have enough in the tank. Meanwhile, Loretto saved the best till last. He leads the way with a tremendous 6:53.22. And I wonder if anyone can beat that time. What a performance. We come on to the penultimate pair, representing Japan and Senshu University. It's Tanagaki Yuto. And he goes up against the Italian from the University of Rome, Daniele Di Stefano. Can Tanagaki or Di Stefano challenge for a place on the podium? Provisional fourth place for Daniele Di Stefano. Provisional fifth for Tanagaki Yuto. Just a little behind his teammate still, and sitting in third place, but look at that split time, 33.03 for the last 400 meters. with three to go. Can he maintain that speed? Needs another low 33 to challenge his teammate Lorello, but you can see him pumping really hard here. Looks like we're going to see another Italian pushing for the podium. Just outside the time still, in fact, just slightly drifting away from Riccardo Lorello, but a good chance here for two Italians to be in the top two positions. As Daniele Di Stefano just grimacing down the back straight into the final bend, all his energy going into this last 200. He comes around the bend, he's still pressing hard. Look at those quads working away, gliding down the final straight. 6:53.22, the best time set. And it's another Italian in second place with a 6:55.22, which also would have smashed the previous track record by 7 seconds. Impressive stuff from the two Italians, Daniele Di Stefano. At the moment, it's Viva Italia. So last pairing here, the last two to challenge for the medals. So Sagatov versus Endo. So from a timing point of view, these two have got the best times over the 5,000 meters. And there is the leader of the pack right there, setting an amazing time. Riccardo Lorello looking on to see what this pair can do. Still a way off, you have to say. It looks like Lorello Di Stefano and Alito safe in the podium positions. Still a goal, drifting further away now. Bakdulat Sagatov of Kazakhstan just went out too slow, and he's not built up enough speed. He's not got enough energy left in his bones. Endo back in 15th, drifting even further away from the leading time. Sagatov coming around the final bend, putting everything into this. He wants to set the best possible time that he can. He's coming into the last 50 meters. 7:03.03 to get in the medals, not quite, I'm afraid, and he finishes in fifth place. Bakdulat Sagatov, not quite enough, and there is the hug between the two leading Italian athletes as Endo comes over the line in 15th place with a 7:15.75. But what a day for Italy. Riccardo Lorello of Italy smashing the track record and taking the gold medal from his teammate Daniele Di Stefano, who was just under 2 seconds off his time. And it's Japan's Arito Motonaga completing the podium in third place, 10 seconds back. What a tremendous session again here at the James Sheffield Skating Oval. Yet another track record smashed to pieces here at Lake Placid 2023.